These days, we're all talking about cryptocurrencies. I bet that a lot of you have at least considered once in their life to buy some Bitcoins, and maybe you even own some. Today, I'd like to consider something very important, which is energy consumption. Because these cryptocurrencies, like most of technologies, come with a cost. It's important that we're all aware of it. So in this video, I'd like to show you the energy consumption of two of the most famous cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin and Ethereum. But before starting, we need to understand a basic concept in energy, the watts. A watt is a joule per second. For our purposes, it doesn't really matter what a joule is, other than knowing that it is a bit of energy. Just keep in mind that a watt is then a bit of energy per second. Think of it like this. If you were measuring the flow of water coming from your kitchen faucet, you might decide to count how many cups came out per second. Measuring power is similar. The only difference is that you're measuring the flow of energy instead of water. A watt is pretty small. A small light bulb might consume 40 of them. A hair dryer uses 1500. A power plant might generate hundreds of millions of watts. The largest power station in the world, the Three Gorges Dam in China, can produce 22 billion of watts. So a kilowatt is 1,000 watts, a megawatt is 1,000,000 watts, and a gigawatt is 1,000,000,000. To give you a reference, a city like New York City needs something like 23 gigawatts on average. Alright, so let's get an understanding on how much energy Bitcoin consumes. This energy is consumed by all the computers that take part of the blockchain protocol. If you're unfamiliar with what the blockchain is, I would suggest you to watch my previous video that gives a comprehensive explanation about it. The Bitcoin system consumes an average of 124 terawatt hours, and this means that the system needs an average of 124 terawatts over a period of an hour. This is the same amount that is needed by the whole country of Norway. Now, this might sound to you as a huge number, and in fact, it's a lot of energy. But like everything, we need to put things into perspective. So then we should ask ourselves this question. How much energy does a banking system consume? Well, with some good approximations, a traditional banking system should consume around 140 terawatt hour. As you can see, this is more than what the current Bitcoin infrastructure is consuming. You need to keep in mind, though, that a lot less people are using Bitcoins compared to people that are using a traditional banking system. So Bitcoin generally uses a lot of energy, and this is mainly due to several inefficiencies that are part of the protocol. It's not surprising, though, since it was the first cryptocurrency that was ever created. Let's now move to Ethereum, where things get better and a lot more interesting. So for those of you that are unfamiliar with Ethereum, this is a cryptocurrency that is somewhat similar to Bitcoins. After Bitcoin, it is the second largest cryptocurrency by market capitalization. In addition to its currency functionalities, the Ethereum blockchain allows for the development of decentralized applications and smart contracts. So Ethereum consumes an average of 48 terawatt hours, which compared to Bitcoins is a lot smaller, by a factor of 3. If Bitcoin consumes more than 5 times the amount of energy needed by New York City, Ethereum only consumes double that amount, which still is a pretty significant number. But here is the great news. Ethereum is working on a new protocol that will reduce by 2,000 times the amount of energy it consumes. If you're interested, this new protocol will be based on what's defined as a proof of stake, while what Bitcoin and Ethereum are currently running on is called a proof of work. Again, if you're curious about this, you should check out my video about the blockchain, where we go over this concept with a lot more details. So in order to recap, let's compare these different protocols by their energy consumptions. Watts are great, but it's not that easy to understand differences when we talk about giga, tera, and mega. So instead of using them, let's just use a much more familiar concept, heights. So Bitcoin is the system that consumes the most. So let's represent it with the highest building in the world, the Burj Khalifa. Compared to that, the current Ethereum energy consumption can be represented with the height of the Eiffel Tower, which is about a third of the height of the Burj Khalifa. But the new Ethereum system, based on the proof of stake, will consume 2,000 times less what the current Ethereum is consuming, which in our height representation corresponds to the length of a pencil. So as you can see, cryptocurrencies and blockchain use a lot of energy, but engineers all over the world are working hard to reduce this consumption as much as possible, so that hopefully in the short-term future, we'll be able to interact with some more sustainable systems. As always, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to the channel in order to make sure they're always updated with the newest videos. And if you have any questions regarding this topic, make sure you comment the video below.